Hello and welcome, fellow Wasteland Survivors. Nasty Bones here, and today's video is the last one in my three-part series on how I build. Today I'll be working with barn and warehouse objects, and we'll also be blending concrete and vanilla objects in with them. Now, I do recommend that if you haven't seen the first two videos in this series, you might want to check them out. They could help you understand some of the more complex tips and tricks that I'll be showing in this video. Alright, first of all, I'd like to talk about a few objects, how they snap, and their snap points. And let's start with these barn floors. Now, they do snap, but there are a few places they just won't snap. You have to actually add other floors in to make them actually snap correct. Second of all, if I do say or refer to the word barn, I'm actually referring to both categories, barn and warehouse. The pieces are exactly the same other than their textures. Now let's take a look and see how the barn walls actually snap to a concrete wall. And as you can see, they don't snap on the ends like the vanilla walls did, but they do still snap on the surface, exactly the same way as the vanilla walls did. Now, there is only one snap point on the concrete wall, and that's the bottom. But there is a second way it will actually snap, and we'll see that here in a second. So the concrete wall has one snap point, but the barn walls actually have two snap points. And what I mean by that is you can actually take the bottom snap point of a concrete wall and snap it to the top of a barn wall, and it works with both sizes. This is a great tip for adding multiple or different types of textures to your build, inside or out. With a barn wall snapping to the bottom of the concrete, your possibilities are endless. Now, there really are only two other type of objects that will actually snap to a barn wall. The concrete roofs and the vanilla roofs will not. What they are is, the first one is the floors. Pretty much any floor will snap to the top of a barn wall. Now, I do have an upper shack floor, but you can see the ceiling is sunk down into it, so that was not the actual snap point. Now, the third thing that will actually snap to a barn wall, of course, is the barn roofs. They do snap in, but there's kind of a limited amount of stuff that will actually snap to a barn roof. And as you can see, this vanilla roof will not snap anywhere on there, as well as a concrete, so I'm not going to go ahead and show that. Now, there are a couple of other different roofs in the category that will snap. For example, this flatter roof. It does have two snap points in the front and the back, but none of the other angled roofs will snap in that fashion or that manner. So now let's say we wanted to build a roof that's multiple stories long. This is how I do it. I just take out the floorboard here and take a barn wall, go ahead and place it in, and snap your roof to it. And you can continue your roof as far as you want to go doing this. But there is a little bit of a gap there, and I don't like it. So my next tip is I use the concrete curved wall trick to drop the floor down one level lower. Then I go ahead and place my other floorboards down to that level, take out the first floorboard like we just did in the previous segment, and then drop the ceiling down to it, and it become much tighter. Now, this is the thing. You could do this as much as you wanted to, as far as you wanted to, but you have to drop it one floor lower than the floor you just dropped to continue this process. And then you would just replace the floor back in at the height that you actually wanted it. Now, I'd like to discuss a couple of things before we continue. That's because later on in the video, I'll have a couple of tips and tricks, plus my secret tip, and they'll be directly related to this. Now, the first thing is the height difference between a vanilla wall and the barn wall. And as you can see, it was quite large. The second is the build order. If you have the barn wall in first, the vanilla wall will not go in. Now, one of the reasons is we already discussed in video 2, but the second reason is because the vanilla wall sticks out from the floor just a little bit, whereas the barn wall does not. It actually sets inside of the floor the width of the barn wall. Also keep in mind there is a fairly large collision point at the end of a barn wall, which helps us sink it into objects a little farther than they normally would. So just make sure that you place in the vanilla wall first, then go ahead and place in the barn wall. Now over the last couple of videos we have discussed group select, but let's say that we want to move these two pieces of glass higher than the height of this concrete pillar. Well, this is my tip. Just go ahead and group select it like you normally would, bring the first pillar out of the dirt as far as you can, and place a second pillar at its foot. Now make sure that you group select the last object that you put in, and now you are twice as high as you normally would be. And you could continue this stair step pattern as high as you'd like. Now, as a quick mention, these posts that are found in the barn section can be used as well. But I do group select this bottom post, and as you can see, the top one didn't come with it. They are a pain in the butt. I do use them once in a while for certain objects, but overall, I would recommend staying with the concrete pillar for your group select needs. Now let's take a second and talk about a collision issue between the concrete walls and the barn walls. If you snap a concrete wall in above the barn wall, it snaps in fine. But if you try to snap one in below the top of a barn wall, it will not snap in. And you can try doing build order and moving things around, and no matter what you try, you cannot get a concrete wall to snap in lower than a barn wall. But in the next segment, I'll show you how I actually can get it done. And as you can see, the build order didn't help us out one bit. It still will not snap in there. It just wants to snap to the outside. So, here's my tip. Leave a concrete wall in or a marker in to help you line it up. Grab a concrete pillar, and usually a flat surface is the best way to do this. But since this is just a demonstration, I'm not worrying about it. Go ahead, group select your pillar and the wall, and then bring it over to the area that you're trying to insert it into. Line it up the best that you can, and go ahead and release it. And now we have a wall that is in there nice and tight and up against the barn wall. Okay, now I'd like to talk about how many walls it takes in the vanilla and concrete section to match up to the barn walls. I have 3.5 barn walls up, and over here I've got 4 concrete walls. But first, did you notice how that just jumped in the air? Well, it's a quick fix. Just grab the object that you used to group select with, press B, let it go back, and then regroup select again. This issue is usually caused by group selecting something, pressing B, letting it go back, and then regroup selecting it again. And now we'll just bring our objects over and place them in where we would like them. And as you can see, that matches up perfectly. Now, the reason it does perfectly is because the concrete's setting on top of the floor. If it was actually snapped to the outside of the floor, it would be one snap point lower than what it is right now. So there would be a little bit of a gap at the top. Now, for this part, what I'm doing is showing you how many vanilla walls it's going to take. And I'm just using a technique that I showed in video 1 to place our vanilla walls on top of one another. And it takes 4 vanilla walls to match up to 3 barn walls. There is a little bit of a gap at the top, but it's not a huge issue. It actually has 2 snap points. One is the vanilla walls, and the second one is the barn wall. And as you can see, I brought that roof down and snapped it to the vanilla wall. Now, on this part here, I'm just showing how you can continue this look across your floor length. It's real simple. Just use a marker in the center and then add your vanilla walls on. Then all you have to do is just add in your barn walls. And you know, with these tips and your imagination, there is literally thousands of ways that you can texture your walls, especially if you don't forget that other vanilla walls will work in the same fashion or the same way. Alright, now over the next couple of segments, I'd like to show you several ways you can manipulate the height of a concrete wall. What I want to do here is I want to put a concrete wall in and a half a barn wall to create the same height as a regular size barn wall. And I'm going to use these stairs to do it, because they are half the height of a barn wall. Now I'll go ahead and take the stairs out and put my floor back in, and I'll readjust my marker to fit a full-size floor in. But now, one thing to take note on while I'm doing this: when we snap the concrete wall onto the floor, it's going to be lower than the surface of the floor. And our barn wall is actually going to be on the surface of the floor, the top of it. So we would be one snap point lower than what the barn wall is. Well, this is how I fix it. I just go ahead and throw up a pillar, move the floor out of the way, click on the pillar, it rises out of the floor, then re-snap the concrete wall back on. Now, as you can see, the concrete wall is level with the top of the floor, even though it's sticking out on the edge of the floor. Now, the second way is a lot less time-consuming. Just use a half a barn wall. Snap a floor to it, and that way we didn't have to use the ladder, move the floors around. This was a lot quicker way to do it. Then just go ahead and repeat the last part of the process. Put your concrete wall up, click on your pillar, let it come out of the floor, place your concrete wall back on, and now we're going to have a very nice tight fit when we blend the two walls together. All right, now I've added in a couple of more concrete walls. It's time to put our barn walls in. I choose a full-size barn wall and then a half a wall. But something's going to happen here. Because our concrete is snapped to the outside of the floor, our barn wall doesn't line up. But that's okay, because barn walls will actually snap in both directions to each other. And once we do, the barn wall lines up and is flush with the concrete wall, absolutely perfect. Then I'll just readjust our other windows to match. Now, I do want to add windows to the outside, but there is no snap point. So what I do to fix this is just add in another concrete wall to the top of our half a barn wall. That'll now give us a snap point for other half barn walls to go in, or full barn walls even if you want to do that. Yeah, that looks really good. Well, let's go ahead and continue our wall, but let's do it as a corner. And we're going to use these concrete pillars to do it. Now, as you can see, I'm off by about a half a concrete pillar. But that's okay. I got a tip on how to fix that too that we'll see here in a second. So I'm just going to go ahead and continue my lower wall. Now I want to add in the windows, but we can't because there is no snap point yet. So I'll move this pillar up to the top wall and then go ahead and add in our concrete walls. This gives us a snap point to add in our windows going in this opposite direction or angle. Now, another positive side to building like this, it's because the way it's built, everything is actually lined up perfectly. We could snap in floors, roofs, or ceilings, and we'd experience zero collision issues. Now, let's go ahead and fix our little gap right there. Now, this one's tough. This is complicated. I hope you got your pen and paper out. First thing you want to do, pull out a concrete pillar, and then just snap it into the bottom of the other one. Super easy. And yeah, that even looks great. It looks like it's part of the corner of the windows right there. Yeah, excellent. All right, let's move on. All right, now here what I want to do is show a way that we can manipulate the height of a concrete wall. And I'm going to do it using a tip that we've just recently seen. And I'll use this ladder and snap a couple of these markers to it, and then make room for a full-size floor to go in. Now the point of what I'm trying to do here is create a snap point that we can actually put a concrete wall on and use it as a marker. And we'll use this one to do it. We'll snap that onto the floor and then we'll bring a third one in, snap it to the bottom, and now we have increased the height size of our concrete wall by quite a bit. Now let's say we want to make our concrete wall as tall as a barn wall. And once again, there's a couple of ways to do it. First of all, we could have just used the tip that we saw a little earlier in the video. But I'm set up a little bit different, so I wanted to show you another way that you can do it under these circumstances. So what I did is I brought the floor down to a lower snap point and added in a second floor. I'm going to use this little three-step to do it. And if I wouldn't have added in the extra floor, that step would have tried to snap to the floor or just wouldn't have turned green when I brought it down. Go ahead, highlight it, bring it straight down, and now it's ready for a marker. And the whole point of this segment is to show there are many ways that you can manipulate these objects into doing what you want them to do. With a few basic tools, a guy or a gal can get very, very creative in their builds. Also, it's leading me up to my secret tips, which are actually another way of doing the same thing, but so much faster. Now, the reason I call them my secret tips is because it's something I've never seen done before. Now, once you see it, you may have. And if you have, shoot me a comment and let me know. But let's get started on them. I'm excited to show you. So what I've done here is I've kind of made a little mock-up build. I've got a couple of floors in. I've got a concrete wall setting on top of the floors. And then I've got a barn wall that I'm going to use as a height marker. Now I'm going to go ahead and grab the concrete pillar, put it in front of this concrete wall, and I'm going to use group select. Then I'm going to go ahead and stick this concrete wall inside of the one that's sitting on the floor. And as long as the concrete pillar is green, I can actually place this wall anywhere I want to. I can take it up, I can take it down, and like I said, it's the same thing that we've just done in the last couple of segments, but it's so much quicker and easier. Now, once I've done this, I'm going to go ahead and bring the concrete pillar around and get ready to bring it over into our build. Now, that's the reason I have the floors in, so it's a little bit more precise. So I'll go ahead and take them out, group select these walls, and bring them over to our build and just line them up and place them in. And this is a great way to do what we've been doing in a very short time. Okay, now there is a second part to this particular secret tip. But before we get to that, I'd like to show you some limitations that you can expect to find by doing this. Now I'm going to put this concrete pillar a little deeper in the ground because I may want to raise this wall higher. Or I could go ahead and use the tip that we saw a little earlier in the video by stair-stepping these concrete pillars. Now, the limitations that you're going to find is if you go above the ground or below the object you're trying to insert it in, it will turn red and you're not going to be able to place it in there. Okay, let's get started on the second part of this tip. If you take a floor and you snap it to the lower concrete wall, but not to the floor that the wall is sitting on, but to the wall itself, you can actually snap the lower concrete wall in and out. This is one of the rare times that this actually will work. Throughout this entire video series, we have saw several times the collision issues that arise by trying to snap lower objects into higher objects. And all we have to do is just go ahead and add on our other walls, snap in our lower walls, and not only does it work doing this particular tip, but the few segments we saw before this one, it'll actually work with that one as well. And you don't have the collision issues that normally arise. And now let's go ahead and get ready to group select it and move it over into our build. Now I did forget to move that marker, so I had to take it out real quick. But since this is just a demonstration, I don't really spend a lot of time to actually line this up the best that I could. Now I am a little lower than the build, so I do experience a couple of issues of it turning green here. But finally I get it in and I just say, okay, good enough, let's just go on from there. And you can see that we got it in, but it is a little bit offset. It's not actually quite up against the barn wall as tight as we could have gotten it. But that's okay. For this demonstration, that'll work out just fine. Now at this point, all we have to really do is just choose what walls that we want and go ahead and snap them in. And once again, I'm just going to go ahead and use these little half barn walls that have these glass windows in it. I like them. I think they're pretty cool. And then we'll go ahead and snap a couple of more concrete walls up. So that way we have something to snap our inner walls to if we choose to put them in. All right. As the final segment for this particular video, it's actually a continuation of what we've been doing. But the difference is we're going to actually use vanilla walls. So what I've done is snapped in a vanilla wall and a barn wall that we're going to use as a height marker. Then I go ahead and group select another vanilla wall and insert it in. Now I am running into a collision issue right now. And the reason is because I have my concrete pillar just a little too close to the wall. And it's actually colliding with the wall that we have snapped in. So I'll take just a second here and line it up the best I can, height-wise and width-wise, and then go ahead and release it. And we end up with a very nice-looking vanilla wall that's actually as tall as a barn wall. Now, the next thing to take note on is we can't actually snap in multiple walls like we did the concrete walls. We actually have to snap them together in a different location and then group select them and bring them in and do the same thing that we just did with the single wall. And from this point on, it's as simple as just adding on some roofs or ceilings and building it however you want to build it. All right, everybody, I think that's about all the info I can jam into this video today. But before I say my final goodbyes, there's a couple of things I'd like to mention. First of all, just because this is the final video in this series, it doesn't mean that I don't have a lot more plans or videos that I'd like to put out showing more tips and tricks that I do. Also, after the credits, I do have a walkthrough on a build that took me about 5 hours to make using some of these tips and tricks. So, for you diehard fans, if you'd like to stay, I do have a pretty cool little build to show you. And for all those who are not going to stay, thank you. Thank you very much for your precious time and your support on my channel. I do appreciate it a lot. And until next time, everybody, please stay safe and have a great day. Before we get started, I'd like to say something real quick. If you stayed to watch this part of the video, you truly are a diehard fan, and I love you for it. Also, I'm about ready to break 100 subscribers on my channel, which to me is huge. So in celebration of this, I'm actually going to have a really neat little giveaway. And because you guys stayed to watch this part of the video, you're actually going to hear about it first and get some VIP treatment as well. And I'll explain it a little better at the end of this walkthrough. Alright, first off, this build did take me about 5 hours to create. And what I've got going here is I've got two different types of structures, one on the inside of the other. On the outside, it looks like a rundown shack, because I used a couple of tips that we saw in video one by placing walls, vanilla walls, on the surface of concrete walls. And on the inside, we have the nice concrete, gives us a nice clean look. Also in video two, I did show how barn floors will snap into the floors to cover any kind of gaps that we might have. And even though I've got carpets down, none of them are covering any gap that I couldn't fill. The floor actually is solid from one end of this build to the other. Now, this was built with the sole survivor in mind. It's a nice, clean, quiet little place that they can come to at the end of a hard day of beating up raiders or running from feral ghouls or just generally picking on deathclaws all day. Now, a couple of things to take note on here is I did use the electrical conduits to make like a little holding rod for those lights. And those lights just kind of highlight up my shelf. Also, I do have the barn ceilings attached to the top of the concrete walls, which is one of the tips that we saw in this series as well. Also, if you notice, I've got glass on my windows. So it's not just the concrete bars, I got actually glass in there as well. Now, I did have a few issues. I wanted it on the inside, but I ended up opting to put it on the outside. And, you know, it's just really nice, clean look. It has a lot of the tips and tricks that we saw over the last couple of videos. And let's take a final look outside real quick, and then let's look at this at nighttime. Okay, now as we move into the nighttime view of this build, I've got a little teaser for you. Now, everything here is exactly the same way as it was in the last segment, with the exception of one thing, and that's this flag and flagpole. And you can expect to see tips and tricks on how I did this in upcoming future videos. Okay, as we finish watching the rest of this video, I'd like to describe a little bit more about my upcoming event that's celebrating breaking 100 subscribers. Now, what it is it's going to be a giveaway. And some of you may know or may not know that I'm actually a airbrush artist. I'm a custom painter. And over the last month or so, I've been working on a pipe pistol, an authentic looking pipe pistol. And it's almost done. And because you guys stayed and watched the rest of this video, I would like to show my appreciation to you for doing that by giving you guys an extra 10 entries into this giveaway. Now, the way this is going to work is only the people that are subscribed to my channel or people who subscribe to my channel between now and the drawing are going to be eligible. And everybody automatically gets one entry. But now the way that you can redeem your 10 extra entries is if you'd like to, go to the comment section and type in my nickname. Now you can go ahead and put it in as a full comment, or you can just type in Bones. Either way is acceptable. It's just a way that I can see who actually stayed and watched this video and who's eligible for these 10 extra free entries. And in the next month, we're just going to go ahead and have the drawing, and I hope that you win this pipe pistol. All right, thank you for staying and watching, everybody. I do appreciate it. And until next time, please stay safe and have a great day.